Good morning, everyone. So today we are here in NDIM campus, and I'm very excited to interview one of the most prestigious, guests that have ever arrived to our campus. So today I'm going to interview Mr. O.P. Rawat, who is the Head Election Commission of India. So let's go and see what are his views regarding National PR Day in relation with the upcoming commission elections of India. Good afternoon, sir, and welcome to NDIM.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
So today you were here for an event. So would you like to just give it just about the event? You know, just tell about what you actually were looking up to the event and how it actually went on.
It went on well, and National Public Relations Society of India, they organized this with a theme which concerns elections. So that interested me, and that's why I participated.
So in the last elections, there was a stir in youngsters that there are various political parties which are nowadays hiring PR agencies for actually cleaning up their image, which we as citizens of India think that this person or this candidate is from this party, so maybe this party is not working well or something is wrong. So what is does it actually happen that they hire PR agencies for these things?
Yeah, that is happening. We are hiring PR agencies, and I think that is fair. That is not barred. What is barred is harvesting data of the voters, profiling based on this data, and then creating some targeted messages and sending those messages to them to influence their voting behavior. That is something which is serious, and we all must do something about it.
And sir, it's like this PR, which is actually the PR image which is actually created during these elections, like which happened for the BJP last year or other political parties per se. So do you think it is very time, the PR image which is made by these PR agencies? So what is your take on it? Should it be maintained throughout, and should the policies be gelled up so well with the PR initiatives taken by these political parties?
Actually, one would like that all those political leaders who project themselves as the well-wisher of the people, they remain well-wisher even after getting elected. But it doesn't have to do with the PR, because PR means you have to polish the image and present it in a manner for the occasion that you get your desired result. That's all. Beyond that, PR agency doesn't have any concern. So it is devolving on the political leader to maintain that level of concern for the people, to the marginalized, and all those whatever he has been professing, has been telling.
And as somebody like you, who has so much of experience in the field of elections and PR, so how do you think the PR started off in India, and it has changed over the past years? Has it evolved, or has it actually stepped up into new dimensions of technology when it comes to going on social media platforms?
Actually, PR in India starts in mythology. Narad Muni used to be a great PR man, creating troubles here and there, whatever. So the PR is evolving here, and I think it is evolving in a positive direction. And technology is also supporting the PR profession. And youngsters like you getting into these kind of jobs will definitely add value to this profession.
As I am a digital marketing student, so what do you think that digital marketers actually have a role of positively or negatively presenting, carrying the entire PR thing forward in the society? What do you think will be the the guidelines? What will be the guidelines or the instructions, or maybe some suggestions you would like to give our young MBAs who are just passing out and who have to actually conquer the world? What will be those 2 to 3 guidelines or suggestions?
I think any type of code of conduct or guidelines or instructions or regulations would mean something negative for this profession. It should be self-regulated. It should come from within, that whatever you are projecting, should be connected to the reality. And if you have maintained that, you have done your duty very well and you will never fail. But if something very hollow, which is just non-existent, is being presented by you through PR, you may also be sure within your heart that this is going to fail. That will really succeed. That is what is required.
And do you think, as citizens of India, how we can contribute to the, you know, positive side of PR? How, what can we do in a way, like acting as responsible citizens, you know, during these elections? How can we help the Election Commission of India to actually, you know, conduct the entire process in a very systematic and peaceful manner?
Wherever you see any issue, any problem, any need for improvement, if you apply your skills, if you apply your education, if your resources, in a manner to improve that situation, that will be serving our country well. And this is what I told during my talk, that when I made an appeal in Bangalore for IT firms, for IIMs, for, you know, people from all walks of life, that don't think that Election Commission alone can deliver such. Please come forward, control fake news, do something about this social media aberrations. And I told that many of them have done wonderful work.
And sir, I just wanted to ask that you earlier mentioned during the conference and the celebration, which we have just come, you know, to the end of the event. So you mentioned that there will be voting for people who are doing jobs outside their hometowns. So will it be for the region they are actually staying in, or will it be for their hometowns where they actually have their vote banks, like they are registered
right
there?
Right now, wherever you are registered, you have to come back and vote there. This is the situation. If you are migrated and if you want to register there and vote, even that is possible. So both places. Wherever you have the permanent resident, you can go back and vote. So that will be legal. If you don't want to vote there, where you have shifted, you want to register and vote there, you can do that. That is legally possible. However, when this electronically transmitted postal ballot system, if it matures into both way electronic, then it can be thought of to amend the law to facilitate the voter a choice. What you want. You won't have to travel back to your permanent residence for voting. You may vote for that constituency from here. Only that time you will be able to give that choice.
Definitely, sir, as you talked about so many initiatives taken by the Election Commission of India, we thoroughly think that the technology will make, you know, even more enable us to, you know, actually explore the new areas where we can improve our country as democracy, which is very, very large and very, very diverse in its own sense. And I think it would, the results would come out beautifully, and we will hopefully, we will, everyone as citizens will be satisfied with the working of Election Commission of India. Thank
you. I'm sure youngsters like you will strive for this cause. We will definitely get those results. You're talking about.
Thank you so much, sir. It was really a pleasure talking to you.